Do subscribe to IKIDA channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Light reaction and dark reaction. Light reaction takes place in daytime when the sun is present. Along with that, the equation of photosynthesis, that is carbon dioxide plus H2O in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, the formation of glucose and the byproducts. Now this reaction somewhere fits the light reaction. There is a separate equation for dark reaction. Along with that, during light reaction, there is a formation of ATP and NADP. Now ATP is adenosine triphosphates, the energy molecules. Whenever a cell has to do function, it needs energy. For example, whenever you want to work or you're hungry, you want to do something very important, exercise, you need to eat food to gain energy. Similarly, for any biochemical processes, cell needs energy, which is in the form of ATP. Now, along with ATP, there are molecules called as NADP, which provide some amount of energy, but in comparison to ATP, the amount of energy that is gained by NADP is not equivalent. The light reaction of photosynthesis takes place in thylakoid. Remember the stack-like substances? For example, when you place different grana, what you get, the stack-like substance is thylakoid. And this is where the light reaction or the daytime reaction of photosynthesis takes place. During photosynthesis, energy is generated in the form of ATP and NADP. So, on your chlorophyll, solar energy falls down. The equation of photosynthesis is carried out. And in the process, ATP and NADP are generated. Now, to generate this ATP and NADP, there are two cycles that take place. And these two cycles are cyclic photophosphorylation and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. What is the cyclic photophosphorylation and non-cyclic photophosphorylation? Cyclic photophosphorylation means there are pigments or molecules through which sun's energy pass, and they are in a pattern, that is one followed by after, and every pigment follows a certain pattern, that is they are cyclic. When I talk about non-cyclic photophosphorylation, this includes two different systems or two different patterns. There is no similarity or there is no lineage in the patterns, and both cyclic and non-cyclic constitutes the light reaction or daytime reaction of photosynthesis. Now what is dark reaction of photosynthesis? Dark reaction, we all know, it starts after sunset. One. Now during light reaction, there is ATP and NADP form. Remember the light molecules or the energy molecules. Now this ATP and NADP, which is formed in light reaction, is used during dark reaction for a cycle which is called as Kelvin cycle. Kelvin is the name of the scientist who actually proposed the theory of the cycle. It is also called as C3 cycle. Now this C3 cycle uses ATP and NADP gained from light reaction. C3 cycle works or starts with an enzyme called as RUBP, that is ribulose biphosphate. It undergoes three different processes: carboxylation, regeneration, and reangulation, or you can say combination. Now after the C3 cycle, you get usage of ATP or NADP at certain places, and this is how dark reaction or dark cycle follows. So let us see what is dark reaction and what is light reaction. Light reaction is basically synthesis of adenosine triphosphate, that's ATP, and nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, that is NADP. And when ATP breaks, ADP, that is an AMP, is formed, adenosine monophosphate and adenosine diphosphate. Light reaction takes place in thylakoid of the chlorophyll molecule. Basically, light reaction is the conversion of solar energy or photons from the sun into chemical form, that is ATP and NADP. Light reaction takes place in cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. Dark reaction, or the reaction that takes place after sunset. When sun is not present, dark reaction of photosynthesis takes place. During dark reaction of photosynthesis, synthesis of glucose takes place, that is C6H12O6 is basically formed. During dark reaction, the energy that is needed, obviously if you are doing a reaction, you need energy. And during dark reaction, the energy that is needed in the form of ATP and NADPH is obtained from the light reaction, the reaction that takes place in the daytime. So in the daytime, ATP and NADPH that is formed is used at the nighttime for the dark reaction for the Kelvin cycle. Kelvin cycle is basically the cycle that takes place in dark reaction. Kelvin cycle is named after a scientist, Kelvin. Kelvin cycle is also called as C3 cycle. Kelvin cycle uses an enzyme called as RUBP, that is ribulose biphosphate, and this enzyme forms the basis of. I hope you all are clear with the concept of dark reaction and light reaction. Thank you.